Musbah Razak joins us now on Sports. Musbah, nice to have you again.
The football historian is here.
Now, anytime you see Musbah Razak, you should know he wants to take you back memory lane more than 10, 20 years ago.
Without the Indomie generation.
Not the Indomie generation, no, no.
You can know that we used to play football in business.
Without ceremony, novelty, nor lecture, the 30th anniversary of the death of one of Nigeria's greatest footballers, Mudashiru Lawal, on the 6th of July, passed uncelebrated. Not the best way to honor the memory of a patriotic and legendary player who played for Nigeria's national soccer team for 11 years and was part of the 1980 AFCON winning team. Mudashiru Lawal, who once held the appearance record of 86 caps for the Super Eagles for 25 years, died on the 6th of July, 1991. That Eagles team, I actually asked Musbah, please just assemble this for me. So when you hear the likes of Joe Eriko, Zion, 76. Zion, Ogufe Itimi, Muda Lawal, Haruna Ilerika, Baba Otu Muhammad, Kunle Awesu, Godwin Odi, Sani Muhammad, Idowu Obitusin, Otubusin, Ike Ezedima, Christian Chukwu, Samuel Ojebodi, Francis Okere, Thompson, Osiyem, Aloysius Atuegbe, Kelechi Emetule, Sunday Oyekuru,
Oyarekwa,
Kenneth Olayombo, Alex Ngosu, and Ogidi.
Ogidi Rabuchi.
Rabuchi.
Tell us. A lot of those boys also played the All Africa Games.
In 1972.
When the stadium here was opened and our boys scored the first goal to be scored.
In 1972.
73. The All Africa here in Lagos.
Yes, in Lagos.
A lot of
National
these boys.
Stadium.
Yes.
So this same from six lads. Now, tell us about what the 30 years after, how will you describe Mudashiru Lawal? Who is the man Mudashiru Lawal? So that our young viewers, they will understand that. Look.
Well, for me, Mudashiru Lawal is arguably the best midfielder Nigeria has ever produced.
The best midfielder?
Yes, I can confidently say that.
Not even a JJ Okocha?
No. Mudashiru existed well before his time. And I once said on this program that Mudashiru was part of the Shooting Stars team that won the first Continental Cup for Nigeria in 1976. And they had the British coach then, Alan Hawkes.
Yes.
He wanted to take both him and Odegbami to England for professional football. They refused. And when the man came back in 1984, the same Shooting Stars was playing Champions League. He still saw Odegbami and Muda. And I said, you are still in Nigeria. That was when Nigeria's league was the best. Muda, the team you reel out was the 1976 Nations Cup team. The first outing of Muda internationally for Nigeria. That was the team of the first team to win a medal of any sort for Nigeria in the AFCON. They came back with a bronze medal. And they were the most underrated team at that tournament, because the team was only assembled. But at the end of the day, they came back, won the bronze medal, and I remember a young Muda scored a wonder goal against Egypt in the third place match. And that was what brought him into limelight. At that Nations Cup in 1976, Baba Otu Muhammad was rated the best outside right in Africa. Kunle Awesu was rated the best outside left in Africa. But beyond that, Mudashiru Lawal was a welder.
Welder?
Yes, he was a welder. He did not read much and was playing for Housing Corporation in Ibadan when Shooting Stars coaches brought him to the Shooting Stars. And that was where his fame soared. And by the time he died in 1991, he was the most capped Nigerian player then, 86 caps, and with many records. He had the honor of being the only Nigerian footballer with two national honors, MON and OON, and was given the soccer ambassador. Don't forget, Muda was the first African player, to play in the 5 consecutive
Nations Cup.
And Muda was the only or the first African player to score the first goal at the Nations Cup and also score the last goal. This is the last goal in 1980. He scored the first goal against Tanzania and scored the last goal against Algeria in the final.
But actually, when we were talking on phone yesterday, you said the same statement I said now, that Muda Lawal is arguably the best midfielder, and we did a comparison between you and Jeje Okocha.
Yes.
And you said you can stand by it any day.
Not as skillful as Jeje Okocha, but looking at all round quality, was much better than him. He was good defensively. He had better ball control than Okocha. No matter how high the ball is, Muda Lawal would bring it down. In fact, fantastic. You would think that he had adhesive on his boot because the ball will not move an inch. It brings it down. So he's capable of calming things down. Calming things down when your team is under pressure. You are looking for a player to do that for you. That is Muda Lawal for you. Then the work rate. Work rate.
Yeah.
I have never seen a player of Muda Lawal's work rate. You see, people like Muda Lawal, they are bound to be underrated in a team. Because it's not out to show flowery skills and all that. It's just efficient. He gets the job done. He links the attack with the midfield. It sometimes even it does a lot of defensive work for you. That you look at him, you say, this is a complete player. That was why Coach Adeboye Onigbede had so much faith in him. You know, when Onigbede won the contest to become coach of the national team, after that debacle when we couldn't qualify for the 1982 World Cup, Muda Lawal was one of the players that he brought back. You know, the players who played and won that 1980 Nations Cup for us, some of them, Nigerians were already thinking, no, let these people go. We are tired of them. Because they couldn't qualify for the 1982
World Cup.
We were eliminated by Algeria. You know? After we lost by 2-0 here in Lagos. We went to their home and lost 2-1. So after that, we couldn't qualify. They played well in the second leg. I remember Odegbami even hitting the post, you know. So, Adeboye Onigbede invested his faith in Muda Lawal and took Muda Lawal to the 1984 Nations Cup.
Yes.
And he did not disappoint. He did not disappoint. He played very well. You see, when you talk about shooting stars, he was the heart of shooting stars. He was their most recognizable midfielder, their most efficient midfielder. And when you have him in a team, you are confident that he will deliver the goods. Even Salawa Benin sang a song in his praise. Muda Lawal, mono mono ori, papa Muda Lawal. You know, he was that good. He was that good and extremely humble. Extremely humble. You know, many players, because of the talent that they have, they are not humble. Muda Lawal was extremely humble. Remember when he was playing for Shooting Stars here? You know, they were mocking him when he was playing for Stationery Stores, you know?
You know, he scored the goal that sent Shooting Stars to second division.
Yes.
In Lagos. And he was crying.
Yes, after scoring that
goal. Against Shooting Stars.
To tell you how professional he was.
He was crying.
He had a club that he played for many years. Then when he got to Stores, because the rivalry between Stationery Stores and Shooting Stars. The supporters of Shooting Stars wanted to see Shooting Stars relegated. They were not interested in an accord match. So if Muda Lawal had refused to take that chance, they probably would have beaten him up on the day. So he saw a goal scoring opportunity and he took it, but then he wept. He wept.
Well, let's talk about the transition between this Eagles team in 1976 to this 1980 division we're seeing now, because I can see President Shehu Shagari even rejoicing and everything. How many people now made it from this team? How did they transit to this Nations Cup winning team? Was Muda part of them?
Yes. Now, after the Nations Cup competition in 1976, I think that was the foundation for Father Tiko to build a team.
In the National State of Lagos?
To build a team. The team now evolves. After the Nations Cup, there was this Olympics that never took place.
Yes.
The Montreal Olympic in 1976 in Canada, which Nigeria boycotted at the last minute. It was after this Nations Cup that the likes of Aduke, Amisimaka, Sheikh Odebami, and co, they were brought into the national team.
They were brought into this team?
Yes, into this team. And some of the old stars, by that time, Aaron Ileka was getting hold, Kenneth Olayombo was getting hold, Sonny Oyarekwa, Kelechi Emetiole, the man nicknamed Caterpillar, they were getting hold. So they were being replaced. So it was a gradual build-up that led to the Nations Cup again, 1978, where we won bronze in Ghana, where we underrated.
We lost to Uganda.
To Uganda in the semi-final to a double, a brace by one of the Uganda's best player, Philip Omondi. He scored two goals against Okala, and that was how we ended up losing the semi-final. Now the team evolves again to 1980. That's the Shehu Odebami. On the screen.
The player before him.
And from that 1976 team, only Muda, Christian Shuku, Godwin Edie, and Aloysius Atuebu made it to the 1980 AFCON.
This team, Abi?
Yes. Only four.
Odie came from the U.S.
Odie came from the U.S. After he scored the own goal against Tunisia in 1977, he went to U.S. But was still playing soccer. They brought him back.
Okay, let's quickly take this call. Hello.
Hello.
Yes, thank you for joining us.
Yeah, good day, my gentlemen there, GBA and Ayo.
Good afternoon.
I'll be looking to your regular caller there. I mean, regular.
Yeah.
The issue of death is it concerns everybody. If I've mentioned, I've not seen any of you giving us alternative way of raising revenue to kind of carry out and project the infrastructure deficit project that we have in Nigeria. Because without the infrastructure, our economy cannot come alive. Yes, the water in Ghana, this one here, because we don't have infrastructure, that means power and roads. This is very essential. Another thing is that the government is borrowing. Nigeria has not defaulted in any way. I think that our concern should be that we should monitor that money is used for what is meant for in the capital project, not for any other thing.
Let me tell you something before you go. One of the best ways to address this problem is to improve our tax drive. We are not doing enough. I'm sure you read in the papers of one company from South Africa that had been in our country for years.
Making money
and refusing to pay tax.
In billions.
We are killing ourselves. A lot of the big companies here, they don't pay tax. They just bribe officials and refuse to pay. A lot of our billionaires, they don't pay the taxes that they should pay. People who want to be captured in the tax net, we have not captured them. There are so many areas through which resources are leaking. And when this happens, where are we going to find revenue? So we are not doing enough in that area. And people like Okonjo Iweala who have suggested to us, they have also said that we should work on revenue. If we work on taxation, the revenue will go up. We can't, every time, there was a time we needed $1.2 billion. We had to go and take permission from Senate to go and borrow. We can't keep borrowing money like that.
Okay.
It just can't work.
Okay. Let me apologize to my football lovers that Muzwa Razak has been, before the last caller actually called us out. Muzwa, we're talking about this great man 30 years after. And that 1980 squad, those that graduated to the 1980 squad.
Yes, I said only four of them graduated to the 1980 squad. Muda himself, Christian Shuku, and Godwin Odie, plus the last person there was Odie, Shuku, Aloysius Atuebu. Those are the four players that graduated from 1976, 78, and 1980. So after the Nations Cup of 1976, the teams, the foundations started building up. 1978, then 1980. I think 1980 was the climax of that team.
That rebuilding.
Because people were criticizing the national team for not qualifying for 1982 World Cup. But they did not know that their target was met by winning the Nations Cup in 1980. That was
the target to
Fadatuku, yes.
And then the mistakes that were made in Lagos.
Yes.
In that final, in that final qualifier against Algeria,
calling back Christian Shuku.
Christian Shuku from retirement.
From retirement,
and he looked slow, and people like
okay, after he retired,
So because Shuku used to send long balls
to Odegbami,
straight to Odegbami, and then Odegbami would just pass on it. So many people were saying, ah, let's bring him back. That Odegbami enjoyed him more, so we brought him back, but. You know, these guys were younger and fitter, Rabamaja and Lakida Belumi.
And Asad Salah.
So they dealt with us. By the time we brought the late coach of the late captain and coach of the Eagles,
Stephen Keshi,
by the time we brought him in to replace Shuku, the damage had been caused.
Oh, Sivikechi was part of that team?
Yes. No, Sivikechi, yes, that 1982 World Cup qualifier. Yes, he was just coming into the team.
I'm frankly, how old?
You know, having played for the under 20 team, you know, as
Tom
Fimbas played for the under 20 team, he was just being brought into it as a young boy. You know, so he replaced Shuku and blocked the area through which they were terrorizing us.
But by that time, Uatu goes down.
Uatu
goes down. It was a red letter day, October 10, 1981. I won't forget. I will not.
It was painful. In those days, whenever we played a match like that, that everybody would put his hope on. Once we lose, my dad would not talk to anybody. He would just walk. He would not eat his dinner. He would just walk inside this. I said, Jide, Ekpano, Etilekon. It's gone.
You know, it's
the day Brazil beat us 3-0 in 1987. You know, everybody thought that Nigerian under 20 team was too much. When we now played Brazil, the hope was high. They never beat us 3-0.
3-0, I'd be 4-0 gone.
4-0.
4-0.
4-0.
4-0. Chile 87.
Chile 87.
4-0.
4-0. You know,
that team was about the best under 20 team we had.
We had
Ladi Babalola,
Adiola,
Tom Sinos, Lia, John Ene Okon. Very good team. Willie Opara was the captain.
Opara was the captain.
Very, very. Peter Neketin.
Victor, I remember that name.
Victor Ibinoba, Jonathan Akuburie. Very good team.
Everybody thought that we would
do miracles. That is the thing that
when they beat us, my old man just said, Jide Ekpano, he didn't eat his food, just went.
We have Ibrahim from Kaduna.
Hello, good afternoon, Mr. Hankoman, and your two guests over there.
Good afternoon, sir.
Thank you so much. Guy, I'm so very happy for hearing this indigenous issue that you got this afternoon. You see, we cannot live for sport alone. It has so many things attached to it. One, unifying us, and again, giving us some tactics that will give us more high in our revenue generation. You see, this region is what we're talking about. I was so very, very happy because I would like to hear their history more. It is today that I really know about what this man called Mudashu, Mudalawa.
Yes.
You see, we in Nigeria, we did not pay attention to sport. England alone used sport to their own IDL. You see it? And the defense of it alone to give them this food. Now, the advice given by our former minister and special person to this, if Nigeria government will be able to fit on that alone, I believe we get something from that sector. Then, concerning the agri people, the agri one that we touched on the tomatoes upstairs, look at it. So, couple these two things together for us to boost our revenue so that we don't continue to blend
or
follow something like this.
Thank you. On the final notes, these guys, they've made their mark and everything, and some of them are still alive, and some of them are dying in droves. We don't know about them, and government is not doing anything to immortalize them.
Well, that is the bane of Nigerian sport. Mudalawa, even the stadium named after him, is now in total disrepute. The Yashiru Stadium. Yes. Nobody remember that it was 30 years and Muda died, except for the Nigeria Supporters Club, which gave him a posthumous
award.
It is, even those who are living, if not for the present effort of the present sports minister,
yes,
who is doing something along that line, people tend to forget the
I know Chris Achiku is still alive.
Chiku is alive, if not for Otedola, who knows? Who knows? Look at, even apart from football, people like Oganjimo died in penury. Dele Jonathan died in penury. Yes. Sam Ojebode had the decision. Somebody will tell me, one of my friends, that is the only tribal mark footballer that played for Nigerian national team. But he died in penury.
Is Eriko still around?
Coach. He died.
Eriko is dead. Eriko is dead.
I think last year also.
It is. It is also the national
Bonito
ministry.
The exponent of the Brazilian
type of football. Style of football in Julius Berger, in Joe Eriko. So, did they even talk about their family?
We don't remember them. When you go to that Shero Stadium, you ask yourself that, is this the way the stadium? That's not the state that it should be. So we need to honor our heroes. That's where the white people are different from us.
Yes.
All of those heroes of the 1966 World Cup. Do you know 66 World Cup? The other day they were talking about one of them. I thought, they are still alive.
Can you imagine?
They live into their 90s. These people, and they honor them. They always talk about them. You know?
Look at when Finidi George was.
We don't even have record of the matches.
When Finidi George was 50.
It was Ayers that celebrated him.
So that's the way they are. They value their heroes. Here we'll be abusing them. See, Pastor TB Joshua died now. Everybody is now hailing him. That they didn't know that the man impacted lives that much. His own colleagues were abusing him and saying that it's not from God. Whereas, who is a Christian? It's the person who is Christ-like, who was doing what Christ wanted. Somebody was feeding people, he was healing people. Can the devil mandate you to be making people happy, to be feeding people? The devil is about negativity. They were saying he was not of God. Now, after he died, memories. Many people that he had impacted on that, he told them not to talk. Some of them are coming
even
to
the governor said he was giving money.
Yes. Peace. Who could have believed that he even gave the governor of Ondo State money?
Look at the testimony of somebody who wants to contest. That he gave 3 million naira cash. And by the time that one was reaching the stand there, after his meeting, saw a lot of 50 million. The same Joshua. Now somebody just sent him to him, I've forgotten the name of that he met him and said, this is my program, okay, we'll help you. And he gave him 3 million.
From outside of our country, they are torrents of tributes.
No. We don't value until we lose them. Musa Razak, I want to thank you for your contribution. Anytime your viewers see you, they know we want to go into the past. And today we concentrated on late Mudalawa, 30 years after. And the messenger himself, Babajide Kolade Otitoju, thank you for your contribution always. So and it's been Journalist Hangout on Sunday, 120 minutes. And every Sunday, 1:30 to 3:30, and that's our offering today.
You didn't talk about the nickname that Okonkwo gave him. Midfield maestro. Yes, midfield maestro.
Join us on our regular program tomorrow at 5 p.m. And we're on YouTube, youtube.com/TVT News Nigeria. I'm Ayodele Uzuwa. Bye for now. See you tomorrow at 5 p.m.